Hello, welcome back to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we are going to learn how to generate Jasper report in different formats with Spring Boot application. So first we must aware about what is the Jasper report. Jasper report is an open source Java reporting tool that can write to a variety of targets such as HTML, PDF and CSV XML file format. And it can be used in any Java enabled applications including Java EE or web applications to generate the dynamic content, and it reads instruction from .jrxml file. And today in this video we will save the list of users and then generate the Jasper report to represent the list of users in well formatted document. Okay, let's see in the code how to generate Jasper report. So first opening my Eclipse, here you can see the Spring Boot project, and it is my main class and it is the my controller class. In my controller class I have already created one endpoint that will get the list of users, and it is my model class that contains 5 property, that is ID, name, age, city and email. These 5 properties of users, and here I have created one service layer that will store the list of users in memory storage and return the list of users to my controller. And here I am injecting the user service class in my controller to get the list of users. So okay, first I will run this application. Now I will go to my browser and hit to the URL. Here you can see the list of users. I have stored 10 users, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now I will generate the Jasper reports to represent the list of users in PDF file or in HTML file. So okay, let's see in the code how to generate PDF file or HTML file by using Jasper report. Now I want to generate the Jasper report in PDF format to show the list of users. So first I need to decide the report format and its title and alignment and everything we need to decide first before generating the report. For this I will use one third party tool, that is Jasper Soft Studio. So here you can use any tool, but here I will use Jasper Soft Studio. So first I need to download this tool. So go to browser and paste this URL here. Here you will see the Jasper Soft community and Jasper Soft Studio, and from here you can download the Jasper Soft Studio for your Windows system, that is in zip format or in .exe file extension folder. I have downloaded from this link .exe, and I have already installed in my PC, and I have provided the link of this URL in my description, so you can download it from here. Okay, now I will open the Jasper Soft Studio. Here you will see it is the Jasper Soft Studio, and it also looks like an Eclipse, and it contains 2 tabs. One is repository and another is Project Explorer. First I will generate Jasper report and then I will customize it according to my model property name. So first I need to generate Jasper report by click on file and then click on new Jasper report. Here you can see multiple template and you can choose any one, and here I will choose this one, simple view, and then click on next. Here you can define any name to your JRXML file. Here I will assign user .jrxml because in my report I am representing the list of users. Then click on next. Here you will see data adapter, and in drop down you will see two. So you need to choose simple DB database connection. Here now you will see the public, and after click on public you will click on table. Here you will see the list of tables, and here you need to write one query: select star from orders, and click on next. Here you will see the data set fields. This is the number of data set fields, and but we need to use only 5 properties. So from here I will choose 5 fields. By double click you can add, then click on next. Next, after that finish. Now will you see here, it is the format of file Jasper report. Now you can customize the title by double click. So here I will write gain Java, and you can add description by double click. Here I will write user list, and here you also need to customize the column header name according to your model property name. Here my model property contains 5 fields, so I will customize this model property name according to my column header name according to my model property, and here the field name will be same like as model property name. So here I am customizing, and it will be the city and email. Now click on the source folder. Now you can see the code of .jar.xml, and you need to modify this. Here no need to use query string, because here we are using our own user list, not using data from any other. So you also need to remove this. Here you need to remove this and customize the field name also according to our model property name. Use the same name that we have given in our model property name: ID, name, age, city, and the last one is email. And also remove these two property name from every field, and then check the data type of model property, and if name is string type, integer type, and the city is also string type in our model property name. Here you can check city is also string type, and email is also string type. Then save it. Here you can see our description and title in our source code, and this is the column header that we have already customized by double click: ID, name, age, city, and email. And now you need to modify the detail. These are the report template that contains in .jar.xml file. Title we have already customized, and we have already customized the column header name according to our model property name. And now we are going to customize the detail, and we'll map the model property name. So go to detail. Here I will use the same name as our model property name. Here I will write ID and name. Here I will use the same name as our model property name. Then age,
And the next one is city. And one more field is left, that is email. And we also need to remove this text adjust from every text field, because sometimes it produces some problems and exception. So remove from every field text adjust, just remove it. One more left. Now it's okay. We have removed from every field. Now copy this source code and go to our Eclipse and click here. Here I need to create user.xml file. So here I will click on other file users.jrxml, and jrxml stands for Jasper Report XML. Then click on finish. Now open it by double click. And paste the source code here and save it. Now go to Eclipse. I have replaced all field name according to my model property name in our user.jrxml file. And now I will, here I have already customized, and you can see the design here. I have already customized column header and details report template in my .jrxml file. Now I will write the logic to generate the PDF file and HTML file format. So now I will go to my Eclipse and go to my service layer. Here I will write one more function to generate the Jasper report in PDF format and also in HTML format. So here return type will be string and function name will be export report, and here I will pass one parameter as string in which format I want to generate the file, and its return type will be string. So here I will return some message. So first I need to load the list of users. So first I will get the user list by calling the function get user list. After getting the user list, now I will load the file and compile it. So now I will use file is equal to, and I will use here resource utils get file function, and here I will pass the path of my .jrxml file. I have saved my users.jrxml file in my class path, that is inside resource folder. So here I will write users.jrxml. Now I will save it and import java.io.file. It's throwing the exception, file not found, so I will handle and using throws keyword to handle the exception. And now I will go to my pom.xml and add the dependency for Jasper report. Here I have pasted this dependency, Jasper report dependency. This one dependency is required to generate the Jasper report, and here I have pasted it. Now I will go to my service layer, and here now I will compile this file, that is users.jxml file, and for this I will use Jasper report Jasper, and here I will use Jasper compiler manager to compile the file, and here you will call compile report function, compile report, and here I will use the absolute path of the file, get absolute path. Now it will throw exception, and we need to handle this by using throws keyword or by using try catch. Here I'm handling by using throws keyword. After compiling this file, now I will map the list of users to the Jasper report fields. To map the Jasper report field, I will use here jrbean collection data source, and here I will create the object for jrbean data source and pass the parameter as list of user. This is the list of user, and after mapping this, now I will print the Jasper report. Before creating Jasper report, I will create one map that will store string of object, and we can give any names here. Parameters new hash map. Here I will use after this. Now I will add key values inside these parameters. Parameters dot put method. Here I will pass some any value, gain Java, and here I will pass knowledge. After that, now I will use Jasper print to fill the report data into file. Jasper print, and here I will use Jasper file manager, and call the fill report function here. And fill report function, here will pass Jasper report that we have already created above, and here I will pass data source. And now I will decide in which format we want to generate the report. If format dot equals HTML, then file will be generated in HTML format. And otherwise, if the format is in PDF, then it will generate the file Jasper report in PDF format, and after that we will return the output. Now here I will use Jasper report manager to export the report. Here I will use dot export in which format we want to export the file, and here I will pass the Jasper print reference variable, Jasper print, and here I will define the path in which location we want to save the export file. So here I will define the path on which location I want to save the generated Jasper report file. I will paste here this path, and here I will define path and the file name users.html. Like this I will use same. Here I need to change this Jasper export manager function. Here I will use PDF file format to PDF file, and here I need to change the extension of the file. Here I will use PDF. Now it will return the path in which location the file is saved. Now I will run this application. Now I need to create one more endpoint to generate the report. So here I will create more endpoint. It is the REST endpoint, and it will get the return type will be string export report function export report, and here I will pass the format in which format we want to generate. Here export, and here I will use @path variable annotation and same name will be used format, and here I will call the function from service layer export report in which format we want to generate. I will pass from URL, and its return type is string, and it's throwing exception. So we need to handle. Okay, now I will stop this application and run it again. Now I will go to browser, and here I will paste the URL and in which format we want to generate. Here report is generated in the Jasper report folder, and here I will change the format and PDF, and again generated. Now I will go to the D folder in Jasper reports. Inside D, here I will go for Jasper report, and these are the two files. By click double click we can see it is the Jasper report. It is the title of the report, and it is a description, and it is a list of users that we want to generate. Okay, thanks for watching this video.